everybody, and welcome back to the garden. I'm Melissa Allman, and today I'm going to show you what our project was this past summer in the hardscaping department. We did it ourselves. We did have a little bit of contract work done, but you can do this project yourself as well. So let's look at that. And oh, by the way, you can see I'm sporting my Gardenchat t-shirt. Thank you, Brian. And so hopefully hardscaping will be one of our talks on Gardenchat this year on Twitter. So y'all join us there. It's Monday nights at 9 Eastern time, and let's see the video. Okay, my hubby and I are definitely the do-it-yourselfer kind of folks, so maybe that's why we never got around to paying somebody to do our walkway for us. So finally, we decided that it is time. We started at the front steps, and right here you can see exactly what we used. A garden hose to line the edge of the pad that we wanted to pour there. We used a rolling spray paint marker to mark those edges, a measuring tape to get it squared correctly, and flags. Oh, and my strong hubby. And believe me, he worked his tail off. And we started digging this project in August when the ground was as hard as concrete already in Georgia. Mind you, it only took a few days, but just look at that mattock. This Georgia clay can bend anything. But seriously, it was truly like busting concrete. I kind of felt bad for him. Next, we started at the side of the house that goes into the back deck. Now, this walkway was 70 feet long and 4 feet wide. And back in 97, we had put rocks down as our walkway. After marking where we wanted the new concrete walkway, we had to remove the large heavy rocks from the grass. Then we had to dig up all that grass and remove it with a wheelbarrow. We even went so far as to till the ground to make it 4 inches deep to accept the concrete. And then we removed that extra dirt as well. And thank goodness our son Travis showed up to help. And he's in his early 20s, and we sure did need him.
Hi.
Now here you can see how terrible the grass looked because it was so dry that summer. We went ahead and spent the money on a concrete truck and a crew of guys, and they got it formed up for us and poured in no time. We had them stamp the concrete to look like rocks to stay with our log cabin type setting, and these guys worked really hard and really fast. Now they had to bring the concrete to the front in a wheelbarrow because we didn't want the concrete truck driving over the septic tank, and that was not an easy task. We had to let the concrete cure out through the rest of August and September, but we did keep it clean and swept. And we even took a drill and a little wire attachment, a sanding brick for concrete, and a wire brush with a handle, and we knocked off the rough spots that were left behind by that stamp. And yeah, that's me on my hands and knees trying to get it just right. After taking up the form boards, we filled in with some dirt and we spread some smart seed because they were calling for a few thunder showers, and I sure am glad we did that. Next, I used a color chart from a local hardware store to pick out a color of a stain of natural sand. My hubby got it ready for me, and I applied it with a sprayer. Now, he came behind me with a paint roller to get it in the cracks real good. And y'all, it was hideous. It looked like the yellow brick road, and I was not happy. Now, we had already purchased the two colors of stain, so I start applying the second coat. It's called Natural Flagstone, and I used a sponge. And here I am. I'm not happy because the first stain looked nothing like the chart. Well, okay, it did, but it was still ugly in person. I didn't even want to look at the camera. But y'all, this was not turning out. But I couldn't just stop, so I had to finish what I started. It was still not what I wanted. It was just too orange. So I needed to darken it and make it look more real. And I knew I only had one more shot to put the correct color on it, so I decided to let my hubby pick that color out. And that way, well, you know, if he didn't like it, I could say he picked out that last color. So he picked out a stain called Loden, and it looked blue in the can, but I went to work trying to line each and every stone with my sponge to make it look real. I worked diligently into the night. Okay, I'm just kidding. But I did stay focused, and I got it done that day. I defined each rock separately, and I took some time, but I just had to get it right. Finally, we put on the fourth and the last coat of the sealer, and my hubby came behind me once again with the roller brush to make sure it gets in all the cracks, in case I had left any cracks. You can see along the edge, I literally had to take my sponge and make an edge so that it looks like the rock is literally set into the concrete. I had approximately 28 hours in this of just staining. And here I am, finally happy. Finally. And y'all, I don't claim to know anything about concrete stains, but I found out that this stuff was hard work. But if you get started on it, you can't stop. Now you can see here that we did add some solar lights to make it pretty at night. And I even added some containers at the end with some deer-resistant plants. And I really do love it now. Okay, y'all, I hope you saw that it was not easy, but it's actually really pretty when you get through with your hardscape. And the good thing about it is it'll be here for a really long time. So thank you so much for watching, and we will see you next time here back at the garden.